All right, looks like people are starting to trickle in. We'll just do a quick introduction to get us started while people are coming in. Just wanted to welcome everybody to the Finch webinar, Recharge Your Approach to E-commerce Promotions. Before we get into it and get started, we're gonna cover three quick housekeeping items just to quickly mention. At the bottom of your screen, the Zoom interface, you're gonna see a Q&A box. So we would absolutely love to hear your questions, and we'll take some time at the end to answer a few of those questions. Number two, please use the chat function down below in the Zoom interface to let us know if there's any problems with audio, any technical difficulties, anything like that. And then the third thing is the webinar will be recorded, and we'll share all the slides and the recording with all the attendees afterwards. All right, let's go ahead and get started today. I'll do a quick introduction. My name is Ian Feek. I'm the Director of Client Success here at Finch. So I've been with the company now for just over 3.5 years and have over a decade of experience helping brands scale businesses with digital marketing. So my absolute favorite part about digital marketing is the website analytics and the tracking and how that informs the overall marketing strategy. So today's topic of recharge your approach to e-commerce promotions definitely sparked a lot of interest. And I just wanted to say thank you for everyone's time and for being here today. So the second half of this webinar, I'm gonna walk everyone through a couple real life client examples of how we plan and execute media and promotions along with their strategy. And so to start us out today, I wanted to introduce Devron Carlson-Smith. He's Finch's Chief Strategy Officer, and he's gonna take us through the first part of our session. Devron is an incredible, amazing man. He's been building businesses and teams with emerging technology for over 25 years. He's an absolute expert in digital marketing strategy and execution and basically anything SaaS. So Devron, thanks for joining us, and I'll go ahead and turn the time over to you.
Thanks, Ian, and thanks for everyone for joining us today. Before we get started with the actual topic, I wanted to set the stage and give you a brief overview on who Finch is. I see that we have some of our existing customers on the line, and special thanks to you for joining. But for those of you who don't know Finch, let me begin with a brief background of who we are. Finch has been in business for over 10 years. We have about 180 clients across 12 countries. We were founded in Salt Lake City as a software for optimizing Google search campaigns, but a lot has happened since then. And not only has the market changed, but we've also adapted. So today, Finch is a turnkey advertising management platform that can optimize not only Google, but several other channels and ad platforms. So we're in the business of helping e-commerce brands grow using best practices and the right combination of campaign strategies. Finch's power doesn't come just through software only. We are a hybrid between our e-commerce domain expertise and a powerful technology platform to plan, manage, and execute e-commerce growth for our brands. So our main differentiator is that Finch delivers a playbook for e-commerce growth. We define the goals, we capture the right metrics, and we create a forward-looking strategy, which is then implemented and tracked fully inside of our platform. And there's three ways we do that. We do that through our collaboration engine, which is an integrated task management tool. We have an optimization, which focuses around campaign structure and bidding optimization. And we have an insights engine, which really focuses around the campaign performance across the channels. So in summary, Finch's purpose is to offer a strategy and a platform to help brands grow their businesses digitally. So let's take a look at the agenda for today's session. This promotions event is a part of a series that explores categories high on the radar for our clients and the brands we work with. As part of this series, we delve into key topics and strategies that are widely deployed and often sometimes misunderstood. Previous topics that Finch has focused on have included setting the right KPI and attribution models for your business. We did a holiday readiness course, and we built out the right channel strategy for growth. All of these can be found on our website if you'd like for more information. But today we're going to take a closer look at promotions and the best way to leverage this category for consistent business growth. So the five topics we're going to cover today are, firstly, the competitive situation and the buyer psychology. We're going to look at the types of promotions that are out there and how to set goals and the best way to engage a customer base. Ian's going to take us through in the second half several industry examples to show you the do's and the don'ts. And finally, we're going to be setting an ideal promotion process. How do you plan? How do you get the strategy right? And then how do you execute? We'll also have a little bit of time for Q&A in case you have some questions that pop up. So let's kick off by asking a couple of questions on your behalf. We're going to suggest a poll, which is going to come up on your screen for these three questions. How satisfied are you with your current promotions? What's the biggest challenge you face? And how often are you running these promotions inside of your business? I'll give you a second here. You should see this coming up now. Okay, some results are coming through. Fantastic. So it looks as if most people are satisfied or okay. And then we have a couple on the opposite ends of the spectrum. So what we typically expect, biggest challenge, manual handling and execution is certainly showing up as being over-indexing right now, followed by evaluation and incrementality. As far as the promotional time frame, looks like people are running it mostly monthly and more than once a month. So that fits typically within the range of our expectations. Okay. So let's move on. Okay, whenever we go through any of these sessions, we want to spend a bit of time on the definition to make sure we're all talking about exactly the same thing. So the definition of promotion is important. So let's get an understanding of what we're talking about here. So promotions for e-commerce are always about offering products with special features or discounts. They're specifically to online shoppers only. They offer a limited time period. And they're designed to drive sales, increase brand awareness, and strengthen customer loyalty. So it's important to note that promotions should always include a special offer of some sort for a limited time, but not necessarily price-driven. And we're going to focus on that today. A lot of people think that all promotions have to be very heavily focused on price. One of the things that we should always include when thinking about promotions is including a measurable goal and setting out to understand what it is that you're trying to actually promote. Is it new audiences? Is it sales? Is it clearing inventory? Looking at the competitive landscape, it's important to notice that this is a massive audience, and it's both a double-edged sword. So there's 24 million e-commerce companies globally. We see about 3.4 billion online shoppers in 2020. And 53% of US e-commerce shoppers will try new and upcoming brands and products. So there's obviously a huge growth potential, but there's also a lot of noise and the extended competition. So how do you cut through this to get in touch with your online shoppers? Well, promotions is one channel that's been highly effective for years. Today's consumer is looking for the best possible deals, and this process occurs at every point in your sales funnel, not just at checkout. Whether it's during the initial research or when you're on the cart page, shoppers are analyzing their purchase decisions based on price, shipping options, and other benefits. So there's a big opportunity to impact these decisions with a range of promotional strategies. We also should consider the psychology of our buyers, and they're planning and executing our promotions effectively helps pay attention to what our buyers are thinking about. Some of the psychological touch points should be considered when it comes to promotions are the following. Perception of savings. Everybody likes a deal, but comparisons are important to help make your case. Don't just list something at 25% discount. Give the normal price, slash through it, and state the current price. If you're going to discount something, let's make it dramatic. Reciprocity. By offering shoppers something of value, many feel compelled to return the favor by making a purchase, but not always. It's about giving to get. Exclusivity, justify your discounts. Always have a reason. Whether it's the end of summer, you're passing on a special price to be arranged from a manufacturer, or today is a company milestone, make sure you announce why you're discounting. Otherwise, your customers may think you build so much profit into your prices that you can afford to discount everything all of the time. Scarcity. Offers tied to urgency are usually more effective. When the consumer is faced with a buy now or lose the opportunity, the decision is often polarizing. That doesn't mean you're going to get the sale, but there's a good chance a proportion of people will actually close. And finally, social influence. Many people like to brag about getting a good deal. Those who have generous discounts on something feel smarter than the neighbor who paid full price. Therefore, they're less shy about letting others know about the promotion. But some of these principles can damage the business, and we want to make sure we're clear on these. Classical conditioning is the one we see most. This is when you're offering promotions in particular either too frequently or in a way that starts training your audience to wait for promotions before they'll buy from you. Secondly is the perception of quality. One of the reasons people buy a luxury product is to get better quality, or at least the perception of quality. A product that costs $299 may look slightly inferior to a similar product valued at $600. So discounting can lower the perceived quality of your goods. Just want to be careful there. So let's look at the type of promotions that you have here. We talked earlier about measuring your promotions, and promotions can do different things. The four main ways most people run promotions are these: driving brand awareness, increasing revenue, building loyalty, or freeing up your warehouse. Number one, driving brand awareness. Promotions drive attention. We all know this. Running promotional campaigns and generating a buzz definitely creates an opportunity to increase your brand's reach and strengthen the awareness. Increasing revenue. You can attract new customers, and it's a great way of reaching people that have never heard of you. If you've decided to work with discounts, make sure you've computed the lifetime value that each new person brings to your business. It's easy to see where giving up a portion of your profit or even losing money as a loss leader is one that is worth it in the long run for the sale. Cross sales and upsells to existing customers. Promotions present the perfect opportunity to offer cross sales and upsells, especially by using all the information you have and know about your customer. Building loyalty, using promotions to engage with the customer base on a regular basis. Reward your loyal customers by offering extra benefit for repurchasing. And finally, freeing up your warehouse. Do you need space for new products? Is there a seasonality change coming? It may make sense to boost certain sales of leftover products as a well-placed special offer. Disposing of goods is good business practice. We also talked about the types of discounts that are out there. And we mentioned that a lot of people are focusing on pricing alone. So pricing is the most effective and the most common, but I'm going to show you the alternatives here in a second. Let's just run through the promotional pricing discount options. The first of which is special offers. This is a unique opportunity for customers to save money on a specific item, collection, or product category. It's really helpful to attract users, and it should ideally be combined with a volume discount, which we'll talk about in a second. Percentage-based sales. One popular way to offer pricing discounts is through percentage-based discounts. This can include smaller incentive percentages like 5 to 10% off, or it could be a 20 to 25% off, or even more significant like 50% plus to liquidate merchandise or something that's not moving. It may be beneficial to offer your customers based on purchase prices where you're bundling, such as two or more to get one free. Coupons. Coupons are codes your customers enter during the checkout process to redeem a specific offer. These are easily trackable. They can help understand how your marketing is working, and they can be sent to specific customers or your entire user base. Flash sales. A flash sale is a discount or promotion offered by an e-commerce store for a short period of time. The psychological principle behind this is scarcity. The quantity is limited, which means that the discounts are higher or more significant than the run-of-the-mill promotions. The idea here is to drive immediate purchase or impulse buying. Now, if those are the most traditional pricing discounts that a lot of people use, what's the alternative? What else can you do without dropping your prices and lowering your margin? So here are four other alternatives that we like to look at: volume discounts, service discounts, loyalty discounts, and product and package variations. With volume discounts, one of the examples is the BOGO, the buy one, get one free. We've all had one of these. They're very effective. Free samples, free gifts. A free gift with a purchase can be a great way to increase your average order size and or get rid of product that isn't moving. You can set a minimum purchase requirement or a volume requirement to preserve your margins, or offer the free gift as orders over, say, $200. Threshold discounts. The more you buy, the more you save. Working with the percentage-based discounts, free gifts, free delivery, etc. Bundles. Creating a promotional bundle that enables a set of defined products for a fixed price. For example, one camera, one tripod, one memory card for $750. It's a very popular way of bundling to move product volume. Service discounts. This is the same as a price discount, but it's communicated differently. There's a perception of savings without the perception of less quality. So for example, free shipping. Shipping costs are one major reason for shopping cart abandonment. Use free shipping in conjunction with a minimum purchase requirement to increase your average order value. Longer return windows. Stress-free returns is a clear advantage for the buyer, especially during the holiday season. They have more time to make a decision on keeping a gift or a holiday purchase, and even a longer time to return the product. No taxes. Depending on your region, you can offer this as a no tax option. Thirdly, loyalty discounts. Using a reward card, reward points, or club membership, you can track repeat customers and offer them special discounts. Loyalty discounts are integrated and they're integral to engaging customers for long-term value. Product and package variations. Depending on your business type, if you're a brand or a reseller, product and packaging variations can be a huge opportunity to increase your sales without offering pricing discounts. For example, limited edition. Collaborate with another brand. Creating a new product with limited availability for a limited period of time can be very effective. Being aware of customer trends and the psychological pattern of scarcity can move product. And finally, personalization. It's another form of limited edition, but it can be the possibility of adding a personalized element. For example, what Coca-Cola did with adding personal names to their product. And finally, just before we kick off with some examples, I wanted to think about the idea of aligning your promotions to themes. We talked about always having a why. When you think about the whys, think about either external themes or internal themes. External themes are easy. We see these a lot. It's events, it's holidays, it's seasonality. It could be back to school, or Mother's Day, Valentine's Day, Amazon Prime Day, Easter. It doesn't necessarily have to be a physical calendar holiday, but it could be something that brings attention to your promotion. Product usage. Gym equipment demands increases in January. It's a cyclical process. Take advantage and recognize when it's the best time to think about your promotional windows and use those effectively. Internal themes are more indirect and they relate to your own business or your own events. For example, a brand anniversary, a social media reach. This could be about a product launch or a release that you're actually doing. So you can create your own buzz and generate the need for actually doing promotions whenever you want. So I just ran through a little bit of the background of the psychology, the types of promotions are out there, the whys. And what I want to do now is hand it over to Ian to talk about some of the client examples of how we've seen people take and look at promotions and apply them to their businesses.
Ian? All right. Thank you, Devran. All right, let's jump right into the examples for promotional strategies that we have today. We're going to cover three different high-level strategies across three different verticals that we've worked with businesses on. And the three different verticals we're going to cover, the fashion, food, and the pharmacy industry. So the idea of this section is to be able to look outside of the box and give everyone a few examples of how e-commerce companies can use promotions differently within their industries. And my hope is that you'll find some part of these strategies valuable and impactful enough for your own internal promotions. So let's take a look and see what these look like. So vertical number one, the fashion industry. I'm going to give just some high level details about this industry and some common details that we often see with these businesses. They have large product catalogs. They, in this case, they were only selling online, so no retail locations. They also had a very small team with very limited resources. And then their current channels for advertising are for promotions, were for the website, Facebook, Google Ads, and Microsoft. And so I'm gonna do a couple visualizations here as we talk about some of the key highlights and as we discussed and strategized around how to run promotions for the entire year. This is what we came up with as far as the business situation for this advertiser as well. And some of the key highlights are that traditionally seasonality and retail holidays are, you know, your determining factors for promotions in the fashion industry. So spring, summer, fall, winter, and then the major retail holidays, Black Friday, Cyber Monday, Christmas, end of school, there's plenty of them. And so what we found was promoting new collections across the different channels and campaigns during the retail holidays was a great way to impact and increase sales volume over those specific holidays. And then running the ongoing promotions for, as Devra mentioned, the service discounts like free shipping and special offers on a monthly basis. So it seems like there's, you know, always promotions running throughout the entire year, both on the service side and on the actual product side and different product lines. So again, this is one example of the fashion industry and how this advertiser planned out the entire promotion strategy across their entire year. Let's take a look at another example in the food industry. We'll see this one is going to look quite a bit different in how they planned the entire strategy for promotions across the year. So again, some common details in the food industry vertical. They sell online and they usually have quite a few retail locations or at least a mix of brick and mortar and online. A lot of the demand spikes during back to school events for their seasonality with back to school, industrial restaurant equipment, things like that being sold during those peak times. And then some of the promotions for key holidays as well around Easter, Christmas, Valentine's Day, Black Friday, Cyber Monday. And so on this strategy, some of the highlights are and how it's different from the previous as well is that the product catalog on in the food industry may not change as much or as frequent. And we also have identified an extremely high demand during 1 to 2 months of the entire year. And so that should change the overall strategy and the emphasis and focus on the strategy during those key times. And then one last one is we've also added in, Devran had mentioned some limited editions, the ways to use the internal promotions. And so this was an example of doing a partnership and working on a California box or a family edition box in this case for this advertiser as the limited edition promotion during those key retail holidays. All right, now we'll take a look at our last example here for the pharmacy industry. And this one, this was a very interesting strategy. And anybody that has worked in this industry knows that there's a lot of red tape to work with them, which is always fun once you get it down though. And so a couple of the key highlights that I wanted to call out on the pharmacy industry was the B2C and the B2B. So they don't just have a promotion strategy around, you know, retail holidays, but different segments of their business. And so this strategy was focused around a specific promotion for a B2B type customer, and then their B2C type customer, which both would drastically change the way that those promotions are run and the effectiveness of them as well. All right, now we'll take a look and just summarize some of these examples and further learnings and coming out of this planning session. Big sales events are absolutely crucial, but there's also a lot of competition. And so the way that we differentiate and the way that we work within a lot of competition is our own audience data, first party data, and, you know, being creative and out of the box thinking with how we run those promotions so that we're not going head to head up against somebody with budgets that we can't compete with. Part of another learning there as well is understanding the specific product and how it differentiates against the competition's product, understanding the audience, working with the data. And if doing these things, these are the things that allow you to not have to give the discounts on just the price, but be creative in the strategy itself so you're not killing your margins. All right, and we're gonna now move into the actual planning process of how we go about strategizing, executing, and measuring or analyzing the promotion strategy for paid media. And it all starts out with the actual sitting down and planning. Strategy first is we have to actually sit down and plan and understand what are our goals, what we're trying to accomplish. And we'll go through a couple pieces here that just add some context and how each advertiser can go about planning their strategy. Every business is different. And so a lot of this is very much just a structure to get started on what are some of those most important things to understand before heading into running a promotion. So the why, what are we trying to accomplish with the promotion, the goals, customer acquisition, retention, et cetera. We also want to know how much we're going to be spending during those times and expected returns, return on investment, et cetera. Who are we going to be targeting? So obviously the target audience is extremely important in our promotions because it may be very different than more of an evergreen audience or another campaign audience. The where as well for campaigns and channels. We have, a lot of different ad platforms nowadays, a lot of different campaign types. Looks like I just, there we go. And then the what is the promotion types and messages. So the, you know, what are we going to be running in this promotion? Is it going to be specific discounts, loyalty, acquisition, retention? And then finally, how frequent, how often, monthly, quarterly, is it ongoing, the different cadence on when we're going to run the promotions. So that's the planning of the strategy side. And now we're going to talk a little bit about the execution side and a couple things to take into consideration before starting the promotion, during the promotion, then after running the promotion. So a couple key considerations beforehand are going to be the creative, the audiences, getting the campaigns, settings, campaigns built, ready to go. And then also the delivery of any additional communications through email, social, newsletters, website banners, et cetera. And so having the creative developed to the audience that we're specifically promoting to, and then building the campaign specific to that audience. So they're very different than a normal campaign build for an ongoing type campaign. This is very specific to the audience we're going after. And then during the promotion, we heavily emphasize A/B testing and improving and iterating during those promotions. So upfront, we want to understand the KPIs, those most important metrics so that we can make adjustments on the promotions while it's running and continue to increase the performance out of it. And we're often checking bids, budgets, adjusting things as needed, making sure that we're not maxing budgets during the promotion if, you know, if we're seeing conversion rates spike. And then after the promo, this is a really great time to sit down and analyze all of the data that we've collected from the different promotions and also kind of reset the campaigns if depending on how they were set up and how they're executed, but also resetting bids back to normal standard volume periods if it was increased specifically for the promotion. Of course, pausing promo ads, kind of getting things back to normal. And then analyzing the data. So understanding how it performed, how those different audience segments were impacted from this promotion and how the messaging actually resonated with the audience as well. And then I've got a couple key points here as well on the analyzing part. Again, this is my absolute favorite part of digital marketing is the analysis side afterwards. Because that's what informs and impacts the strategy ongoing and moving forward. So a couple of questions that I ask after every promotion or every campaign that we run is, did we hit the goals, the target ROAS, cost of sales, whatever the KPI was, did we hit it? And if not, why didn't we? Another question, did your advertising costs and our increased sales offset your promotion costs? Obviously, we don't want to be losing money on the specific promotion. And so really understanding all of the cost going into it and then how what the resulting return was on that promotion. Which channels and platforms best met the goals? So typically we can run promotions across many, many different channels. And so part of the strategizing and planning process is running them across those channels so you can find which channels and campaign types perform the best and then iterate your promotion strategy down the road with the next one. A couple others, keywords and product categories that are driving the most traffic and then how effective your campaigns for this promotion are compared to other promotions. So if you have several promotions a year running, it's really good to look back at the other promotions and glean insights into maybe why this one didn't work out or why this one was so much better. All right. So we'll go ahead and wrap up here after our examples of promotion and strategy, and then also how we plan and execute the actual promotions. And Devron, I'll go ahead and turn the time back over to you.
Yes. So thanks everyone. What we wanted to cover here today was giving you a snapshot of how varied the promotion channel can be for your business. It's not just about discounts, and it's not always about sales. It could be about new client acquisition. It could be about removing excess stock from your warehouse. But it's definitely about something that recurs, and it can recur monthly, it can recur quarterly, or it can recur on an irregular basis. Part of what we want to be doing with promotions is making sure that we're hitting our numbers, we're learning from each campaign, and that we're driving the next one more successfully. So they're an effective way to reach the goals. Getting your strategy right before you go into them is very essential. It's also very important to be thinking about being creative here. What's the best way to align your promotions to how your audience buys from you and considers from you? So thinking about those external and internal cycles are important. And finally, it's the loop. It's about spending time up front in the strategization. It's about going through the execution process diligently and learning and adapting with the metrics that you learn on the way out of those campaigns. So overall, thank you for joining us today. I'd like to leave it open. If you are interested in talking more about your promotion strategy, please contact either myself or Ian here. We'd be happy to talk to you about what it is that you're currently doing and what you'd like to be doing, and we can take it from there. Finally, I'm just going to open it up here for a quick Q&A session for anybody that had any feedback. One, you can provide your feedback using this QR code about the actual event itself. And secondly, you can leave a question in the Q&A section on the bottom of your screen share. Just leave it a second here, see if we have a question. Okay, so yeah, I have a question here for you. You talked a lot about promotional measurement. Can you suggest what are the best KPIs to be successful in your campaigns?
Absolutely. So most of the time, it's going to be return on ad spend, cost of sales, one of those key metrics revolved around driving revenue and the resulting the resulting value coming from the campaigns. So as far as measurement goes, there's a combination of tools I like to use specifically for the measurement. It's going to be between the ad platforms themselves, Google Analytics, Google Tag Manager. Between all of those tools, you can measure any type of promotion in a way that can fit within your existing data, but also understand it to separate it from the existing data so you can see how effective that specific promotion was.
Got it. I have a second one here. Which ad platforms are particularly suitable for promotion? Are any better than the other for its completion?
Yeah, absolutely. And to the easy answer is it depends, because it's always dependent on every business, the strategy and the situation for the promotion. All ad platforms, though, are going to be great for executing and for running the promotions, but there are going to be some that are definitely better than others in terms of tracking and the media itself that can be displayed. Facebook, for example, being very visual, social ad platforms being very visual and engaging. Those are going to be great for promotions, but that can also be done on a demand side platform like the Trade Desk and Google Ads and Microsoft as well.
Got it. We have time for one more. Let's see here. What's your experience with Suite Commerce Advanced websites running NetSuite and the limitations on their promotions?
Suite Commerce. So that's a great question. Specific to Suite Commerce software, I don't know how that works. But what we do have is Google Tag Manager, and that integrating with being able to pass data across the pixels and send that to the advertising platforms is typically how we work around the variety of e-commerce platforms. And so we work with our advertisers and our businesses on doing those integrations to ensure we have the tracking, we have the data that we need so we can run those promotions. Once that's in place and we have the foundation for where the data comes from, then we can work with the advertiser on getting insights getting insights out of their data to then inform that strategy moving forward.
Got it. We have one last one here. My competitor is always much cheaper on Amazon than I can be. What should I be doing?
Yes, this is a great question because this is happening quite a bit right now with how easy it is to become a seller and start selling on Amazon. And so it really depends on, again, the strategy and the intention. Amazon can be really, really good for new to brand customers or people that already know your brand, depending on how the campaigns are set up in the strategy. Myself personally, I like to go with the owner of the data is going to be the winner for informing that strategy. And so Amazon is just one sales channel that will drive a lot of revenue. And website data can be, still be transacted on the website and collected there. And that information is extremely valuable as well. So I will typically do a combination of strategies across the platforms because of those price differences and competition on the ad platforms.
Fantastic. Folks, that's all the time we have for today. I hope you found this valuable. We will have recorded this session and you will get access to the slides if you wish to go back and keep those for yourself. And of course, there's more material on our website. Thank you very much for attending today. Stay tuned for our next webinar and we really look forward to having you again. Thank you.